With the monsoon, it's our team that will keep you safe. An experienced team with the right information at the right time. That's what we do for you.
SkyCam is brought to you by Window World, simply the best for less.
Now, KGUN 9 on your side, first warning weather with Chief Meteorologist Erin Christiansen.
Now look at our radar, still tracking rain all across southern Arizona for you this evening, and our showers just barely drifting to the north, maybe 5 miles per hour at best. Our storms today have been nearly stationary. That is why we have seen such tremendous rainfall totals, which I'll give you some in just a moment, and how much flooding we have seen from these storms today. Now the heaviest of rain has let up for now. We are still expecting some scattered showers throughout the course of the evening. This does even include for Tucson. So this means over some of the places that are still seeing that flooding. So any amount of rain at this point is going to create some flooding of our roads and washes. Look at the lightning, though. I wanted to switch this over to our lightning tracker very quickly so that you could see that in the past 30 minutes alone, we have had over 4,000 strikes just within this view. So just within southern Arizona and northern Mexico. If you are hearing those rumbles of thunder, you need to be indoors because that means you're still close enough to be struck by lightning. So just to update you now, the places where we're still seeing the flooding: Huachuca City, Sierra Vista, Avra Valley, Jackrabbit, and near the Alter Wash near State Route 286. This is the flash flooding that is still happening. You'll want to avoid those areas. Most of our watches are set to expire right around 6:45, 7 o'clock. But that's not to say that National Weather Service won't extend them well into the evening. So make sure you tune back in with us at 6 o'clock. Mainly the areas of concern here, Southwest Cochise, Eastern Santa Cruz, and North Central Pima County. Those are the areas where the flash flooding is happening versus a flood advisory. When we talk about flood advisories, this is the kind of thing we mean. Washes that are flowing. John Logsdon was in the middle of this one at Malvern Street at Harvard Avenue. This is on the east side of town. Was there to capture that initial flow of water. Hopefully got out of the way in time. Quite the fall here at Sabino Canyon Dam. George Tassini took this photo, sent it in through iContribute. And some of the rainfall totals anywhere from 1 to 2 inches worth across all of these areas. This includes Tankaverde Guest Ranch at the Tankaverde Wash, also on the northwest side at Moore Road and La Cholla. Check that out. Oh my, 2 inches worth of rain there. These are all the spots that have had just about an inch or more of rain. A downpour like this one brings on those impressive rainfall totals. This was taken from the foothills, Craycroft, just south of Sunrise. My thanks to Jody Ayler for that, and Katrina from quite the perspective there. One of those upper levels in one of the buildings downtown. That's quite the deluge. Now we've had just a trace of rain at the airport, but Sahuarita over an inch of rain for you. Saddlebrook over an inch of rain, about 0.4 inches. Thanks to Harvey, my weather spotter in Green Valley. Some wind damage to go along with this. I think it's no doubt that we have had some microburst wind damage today. This looks like one of those examples. This is at the Midtown Tucson Police Station at Hardesty Station. There a tree down, a couple of trees, as a matter of fact. So more rain on the way tonight. Well, here's the timetable. We're expecting 7 p.m. still to our south, to our east. Those showers continuing for Oracle, Wilcox, Douglas. Not so much for Tucson until we make our way into 9 o'clock. Then we start to see a few spotty showers moving in. Tomorrow and Sunday, we have lesser chances for rain. Now a 20% chance for showers and storms Saturday, and then down to 10% Sunday. So still keep the umbrella handy, but most of us are going to have an opportunity to do some drying out. As we dry out, our temps come back up to the triple digits. We'll be at 100 for your Saturday, 101 on Sunday, and a dry start to next work week. Guy?